Hi, welcome to Device Tech Tip channel. Today, I'd like to show you how I typically set up my Windows 10 laptop. I recently bought a new one. If you're switching from Apple MacBook to Microsoft Windows, this is a perfect video for you. Or you could be upgrading from Windows XP or 7 because they started to slow down, crash, and freeze. It is not as complicated as you think. If you're not confident to do it on your own, you can use my video as a guide. Let's take it from unboxing. On the left-hand interface, you can see different ports. The next images show the corresponding cable that can connect to each port. Same on the right-hand interface, unique ports available. Here are the corresponding cables. Let's turn on the power and start the initial setup of Windows 10. I bought this model in Canada, so choice of language is English or French. If you are in Quebec, please proceed in French. Unfortunately, I don't know the language. I will stay with English this time. Click Yes. Next, Cortana, the Microsoft AI assistant, comes on and starts talking to you.
Hi there, I'm Cortana, and I'm here to help. A little sign in here, a touch of Wi-Fi there, and we'll have your PC ready for all you plan to do. Use your voice or the keyboard along the way, and if you'd like me to stay quiet, just select the little microphone icon towards the bottom of your screen. If you need an assistive screen reader, press the Windows, Control, and Enter keys at the same time to turn on Narrator. Okay, enough intro. Let's dig in. Your region is set to Canada. Is that right?
You can speak directly to your laptop as if you are having conversation with Cortana. But I will turn off the volume down this time. Now the screen asks you which region you are in. I choose Canada. If you wish, you can change to a different region. Click Yes. Then it will ask you for your keyboard layout. This model has English keyboard, so stay US and click Yes. If you have extra keyboard you like to add in different language, you can click Add Layout. But I will skip this time. Next is the Wi-Fi setup. I usually skip by clicking I don't have internet because Microsoft will force you to create their Outlook account. I just want to create login username and password. So I do this way. I click Continue with Limited Setup. Now, Microsoft Windows 10 License Agreement pop up, and you click Accept. Please be prepared to click a lot of Yes, Next, and Accept. Because I did not set up Wi-Fi and Outlook account, I have to create a username, which I think it's easier. Enter your username and click Next. You'll be asked to create password, but you can proceed without it. So for now, I will skip by leaving it blank and click Next. I want to keep my setup with more privacy, so most of my choice and setup is no, decline, or basic. Do I want activity history and a digital assistant? No. Click decline. Do I want to do something with my voice?Probably not. And you click accept. Please do not let your app to locate where you are. Choose no and accept. Some users will find these functions useful, but I don't.You don't want to risk your life for a laptop unless you know where you left it, so still say no. And you click accept. I do not want to send any data, but the choice is full or basic. I'll stay with basic and accept.Inking and typing is more useful if you have a touch panel, like Surface. In most cases, no and accept. I thought I was very clear on data of any kind, but I have to be persistent. No and accept.Do I want advertising to track what I have searched and perhaps recommend more? No and accept. I like the product of Acer, but no thanks to registration or email notification. I get way too many emails already. Leave it blank.And next. And click next. Thanks for your patience. We're almost done. That's the end. Now you're ready to use Windows PC. If you like my setup video, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. More initial setup video coming up. Thanks for watching.